I'm going to sit here and I'm going to pray for you. If you're coming to this channel and you're like, oh, I saw that thumbnail and it says prayer for spiritual attacks and spiritual warfare, I need that. Yes, you do. And I'm here to pray for you. So let's get busy, okay? Let's ask God to intervene in your life. So this is prayer for spiritual warfare and spiritual attacks. Father God, I just thank you, Lord, that you're doing miracles right now in all these people's lives, Father. I thank you, Lord, that no matter how they feel, because we can't go by our feelings, Lord, we can only go by the truth of your word, Father God. And so I pray, Lord, that every person that has come to this video because they have some kind of satanic attacks on their lives, on their families, on their finances, on their minds, Father God, on their careers, whatever, and their relationships and their marriages with their parenting. God, we know that you are so great and you are so powerful and you are so mighty, God. Nothing that the enemy is throwing right now can compare to your might and compare to your power and compare to your authority. And I just plead the blood of Jesus over all these people, Lord. Anyone that's watching, Father God, I just plead the blood of Jesus over them, over their situation, Lord, over their families, God, over everything that they're concerned about, Father God. I ask for healing in the name of Jesus. I ask that if there's any person that got a bad doctor's report and they're fear and they're full of fear and anxiety, I ask you, Lord, to remove that fear, remove that anxiety, remove all of those things, Lord, that the enemy is bombarding their mind. I ask that you pour an anointing oil over their mind, Father God, and that their thoughts and their mind and their feelings and their emotions, Lord, would just be captivated by you and your word, Lord Jesus. I pray for a healing balm to go out, Father God. I pray for wisdom, Lord, to go forward to these people, Lord, if they're feeling like they need your wisdom, how to get out of these attacks, how to get through these trials and tribulations. Father God, I know that your word says that you are with us. You never leave us. You never forsake us. And you stop the fiery darts of the enemy. And you put a stop to the enemy's attacks. And that no evil will come near our tent or our door, Father God. And I just plead the blood of Jesus and I thank you, Lord, that your word is yes and amen, and that your word never returns void, Father God. I thank you that we can call things that you've said in your word, and we can claim those things for ourselves, Father God. I pray, Father God, if there's anyone that has depression, that you are there. I want you to know that Jesus is with you. He is for you, and he is all-knowing, and he's in heaven advocating for you. He knows your depression. He knows your sadness. He knows your grief. He knows all those things, those tormenting thoughts from the enemy. I would just say, don't agree with those things, guys. Don't agree. Father God, remove, Lord, remove the cobwebs of like the demonic cobwebs and the ways the enemy's attacking them, bringing anxiety and depression and sorrowful, really hard times, God. Father, would you meet them right where they are? Would you anoint their head with oil? Would you bring people in their path, God, to just come and bring a word of encouragement, Father God? Send your angels, your warring angels, to protect each person, Father, and to stand guard and not to let the enemy even come near them or their family or their home, Lord. Would you help them to apply your word effectively and to pray it out loud? I just feel like the Lord wants you to pray out loud. Come against these things with God. Voice scripture, say scripture out loud and say, I claim this for myself, God, that no weapon formed against me shall prosper, God. And remind the devil who you are in Christ Jesus and that Jesus is inside of you. And you have more authority. You have more power and anointing. And you can break through the power of Jesus Christ in you. Break and have an outbreak and break the bondage of all these things that are happening right now. Do not open your mouth and agree with those things, you guys. If the devil is telling you lies, if he's coming to steal, kill, and destroy you, and he's affecting you, don't agree with it. Remind him who your God is. Your God is more powerful. Satan and the demonic realm are created beings that fell away from God. They are not higher. They are not more powerful. They are not mightier than the Creator, the God of the universe that made everything, that made you and all things in creation that you see. God is powerful. He is more powerful than anything, any weapon that can come against you by the enemy. You need to remind the devil. You need to say, devil, stop messing with me. Get out of my mind. Get out of my house. Get out right now. I do not agree with you. I do not accept you. By the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, you need to leave right now in the name of Jesus. I do not have any ties with you. I do not agree with you. You need to go right now in the name of Jesus and claim what God has for you guys. He has good things in store for you. His good things are spiritually good things, you guys, not just physical. Of course, God wants to bless you and he wants to help you. But I'm talking about he wants to heal you. He wants to heal your heart from wounds and scars and torments and things that the enemy has done through the very, when you were very conceived all the way until you are right now, that God is all knowing, he's all powerful, he is all present. And there's nothing too big or impossible for God. There's nothing. I do not care what the enemy says and is lying to you. Whatever your situation is, we can come into agreement right now that the Lord is working on your behalf and he's going to make things happen. Things are going to break in the spiritual realm. When you align yourself with God's will for your life, when you align yourself with God's word over your life, when you come into agreement with the things of God, then you will see breakthrough, my friends. You will see breakthrough. So Lord, we thank you for your breakthrough. We thank you that even though we're not seeing it possibly yet, you're on the move. Your spirit is moving in me and in the world, and you're orchestrating everything, all the puzzle pieces to fall together, Lord. You're going to make a beautiful tapestry out of my life, God. And what the enemy meant for harm, you're going to turn around and you're going to have it profit me, God. And you're going to have the enemy pay and suffer for tormenting me. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. I hope that helped you guys. That was powerful. I was feeling it. You know what I'm saying? But the Lord loves you. Don't forget that you are his child. If you are born again, you know that the Lord is with you. He never leaves you or forsakes you. He is with you. He is your advocate. He is interceding for you day and night. So even though the enemy tries to go before God and be your accuser, he's the accuser of the brethren, Jesus voids anything that he says or does or tries to put in the mind of God with his accusation. So be encouraged today. Thank you for coming to the Encouraging Word Ministry. I'm Michelle. And if you did miss, I would highly recommend you go and look. I'll try to link it in below in the description box. But I have done scriptures for a spiritual attacks to claim over your life. Go check that out. Thanks, guys. Bye-bye for today.